Testing.
Now, brown cow.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
New York. Unique New York. I'm ready.
You ready?
Yeah.
3 long years later.
Feels like a long 3 years, doesn't it?
It does feel like a bloody long 3 years, Stef. And 2 old podcasts coming out of retirement for 1 last dance. That's right, everyone. It's the Thomas Stef podcast back again for another major footballing tournament. Stef, you feeling good? You feeling excited? Feeling pumped for the Euros?
Yeah, good.
Yeah. Any more enthusiasm than that?
Yeah.
G the fans up. Yeah, great. What's on the menu for this season? What flavour can you give the fans? What can they expect?
It's going to be the same old shit, innit? Although, obviously, Delhi is no more because he's not in the squad.
Will there be another cooking section to replace it? Or?
Look, I don't want to give anything away, but ask me later.
But what have you got, Stef? You got some bits for me?
Well, I've got my poem. Always got my poem. Yeah. I've got a new game. I've got potentially a challenge for the listeners. And then I might have a little cookery segment.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, we've got plenty to get through.
Yeah.
More facts, more poems, more emails in, I think. Let's interact with our listeners a bit.
Yeah.
We're having a song this year, song competition?
You bet we are, Stef.
All right. Do we know who it's about yet?
I'll reveal it later.
Okay, good.
But yeah, should we get onto the first section of the new podcast?
Yeah.
Reading your poem, are you?
Yeah, I'll read my poem.
What's it about? What's its flavour?
It's about the podcast, about the Euros, about us.
Me and you?
Yeah, it's about everything, really.
That's cute.
It's called The Poem. Right. Come on. You got some music for me?
Yeah, I'll certainly dig something out for you.
The Tom and Stef podcast is back after a 3-year hiatus. Sure, there are some nerves. What if everyone now hates us? Quite a lot has happened since the summer of 1-8. And let's be honest, a lot of it has not been that great. From the glorious sunshine and those pints flying through the air, to a global pandemic, millions of deaths, lockdown, not being able to see your family, job losses, sadness, and just general utter despair. But hey, it's not all bad. Tom's Lonely Hearts Corner is no longer needed.
Oui.
And your plan to shut down Delhi's Deli has finally succeeded. So while this year's Euros are a little bit different, I'm sure they'll still be fun. A time for heroes to emerge and sing songs about Jude Bellingham. There are games in Budapest, Bucharest, Dublin and Baku. It's time to conquer Europe, because that's what we do. Although things will be a little bit more refined with table service and waiters, we can't watch the games in large groups, but we won't let that deflate us. A quick look at England. 54 right backs, real talent in our tool bag. With those attacking options, we should not be off to the gulag. Anyway, we want to hear from you listeners, be it good or bad press. So Tom, why don't you read out our brand new email address?
That was lovely.
Yeah. Just something I whipped up, innit?
No, lovely. Yeah, you never fail to deliver.
Yeah,
you never fail to deliver.
Yeah.
So hopefully we'll have plenty more of that coming over the next few episodes. As we plan to do, we're going to be planning to put these out maybe once a week, Stef.
Well, I'm on holiday next week. I'm missing England's first game, but yeah.
Right.
We're off to
when are you going to tell me that?
We're off to a fascinating start. I'm missing the first week of the Euros, but, you know, I'll be in a nice secluded part of Wales, I think, by all accounts. But
when are you back?
Week on Sunday. Should have discussed it, shouldn't we?
Yeah.
Well, we'll work something out.
Week on Sunday.
Could be a guest.
Record on the Monday.
Could be a guest appearance.
That's not happening. All right. Well, we'll figure that out later. Anyway, we're looking at about 1 or 2 episodes a week. But yeah, email address. The thing is, on this podcast, we love hearing positive reviews. We don't mind the negative reviews.
Got to have your critics,
like we say every single year.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's T and S.
Yeah.
Europodcast2021@gmail.com. So I was right.
Okay, yeah. That's good. So we are calling it Podcast 2021,
yeah,
which
yeah,
is
yeah.
fine. But look, as I've said before, I'm going to rush you was a famous feature because it put you on the spot. You embarrassed yourself a few times.
Yeah.
Famously, you said that the Russian currency was a bovnov.
Yeah.
When it's the ruble. But irrelevant of that, I just want to check a few things with you.
Yes.
How many teams are competing in Euro 2020/21?
What, is this some sort of exam now? Or?
Well, no, I'm just asking you. How much do you know? How many teams are competing in it?
24?
Yeah.
Well, next question, Your Honour.
How many host countries are there? How many host cities?
Well, that's a trick question, that.
It's not a trick. It's what is currently?
Six?
11. So,
Halfway there.
A few weeks ago, UEFA increased the number of the squads to allow for sort of fatigue and stuff. What was the previous number and what is the new number?
Previous number, we're talking 24-man squad. New number, you're looking at 26.
It was 23 and 26. So not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad at all, actually.
Yeah.
Who are the current holders? 3, 2, 1.
Portugal.
Yeah, well done. That famous night in Paris, wasn't it? With the locusts.
The moths.
The moths, yeah. So yeah, I think that's a bit of redemption for us there.
I didn't like that really, Stef.
What I mean.
No, because we're meant to be on the same team.
I know, but I wanted to make sure
trying to out me in front of the fans and my footballing knowledge.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but I thought you held yourself pretty well, actually. Yeah.
50-50.
Anyway, look, Tom Caston did ask about food segment, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. What we've got this year, Tommy, nicey-ricey. Nicey-ricey. We've had vodka, we've had gin, we've had Senegalese fish stew. Yeah. So look, I'm sort of streamlining it a bit. A bit more focused approach. Rice dishes.
All rice dishes.
Yeah. No, I'm not fucking about anymore. It's kind of like... I'm just nicey-ricey.
Right.
Just a little homage to Declan Rice.
Declan
as well,
Rice, yeah.
Yeah.
On the nose kind of recipe.
You can't go wrong, I don't think.
Yeah. What have you got for us then? I mean, I'll always give your cooking segments a chance.
I made you some food tonight, and you know you gobbled it right down. So it's there. You know what I mean? The talent's there.
Yeah.
But it's, I don't know. But anyway,
you're a bit like a Balotelli, aren't you?
Yeah. I've got like flashes of brilliance within me. But England's first game. Do you know who we're playing first up?
Croatia.
Yep. Our sworn enemies from 2018. But I wanted to acknowledge their heritage with a salata od hobonis. So what you got there, Tommy?
Right,
it's an octopus salad, mate.
Come on, let's rattle through it.
It's an octopus salad, boy.
Yeah.
So get an octopus. Get a frozen octopus. The recipe.
Where are you getting a frozen octopus from?
The fishmongers.
No, let's dig into this because has been one of the main bits of feedback. Is that people are like,
well, where do you get the?
Yeah. Where genuinely, if I said to you now, go and get me a frozen octopus, where are you getting it from?
Waitrose. Probably Waitrose of all the supermarkets. I don't know.
Yes.
Go to a good Waitrose. I need a whole one.
It's not a bad answer.
Little top tip, wine cork in the water to ensure tenderness. The thing is with octopus, famously, and people always make this mistake, they don't cook it for long enough. It needs at least an hour and a half. Cook it for an hour and a half, pop a wine cork in.
Where are you popping the cork?
Just in the water with it.
Why?
I don't know. I don't know the science. Maybe one of the chefs can get in touch. I know that we've got some famous chef listeners.
Yeah, we've got a couple of Michelin star chefs.
We bloody have. Actually, one of them was in touch earlier tonight.
Let's not distract at the minute, but...
Sorry, yeah. Josh, he said he's got his song ready. Doesn't even know who it's about, but he's got his song ready.
Good on him.
Can't wait for
Good
episode
on him,
one.
Josh.
And I know Christian's been in touch as well, so...
Yeah, Christian, another long-term
friend of the show. But look, they know their stuff, so if they could just confirm this. Anyway, for me salad, Tom. While your octopus is cooking, getting
an onion... Wait, what... What temperature? We're boiling it?
Boiling it, yeah. Full boil. hour and a half. Keep a cork in there. Onion, chop it up. Garlic, potatoes, tomato.
These are all getting boiled as well?
No. Yes, oh, no. Oh, yeah, boil the potatoes in with the octopus. Tomato, parsley, salt and pepper, olive oil, red wine vinegar, half a lemon.
Right. Any rice?
Oh, fuck. Right. And then boil some rice. Stick some rice in with the octopus. This isn't the traditional method, actually.
Do you know what this
the
is?
Rice. No, come on, because it's... I did say nicely ricey.
I'm going to give you two attempts at this.
And this was attempt one?
Yeah.
ultimately, once
it, I reckon people will agree it's been a failure. Get in touch if you think it's been a failure.
When I once the octopus is cooked, chop it up, mix all the other ingredients in, season it to taste, gobble it down.
Tommy's cryptic clues are back. Great prizes to be won.
There's never
great prizes to be won.
Yeah.
All you got to do is email in the answers, right? Simple as that.
Yeah. What's the prizes?
Prizes.
He hasn't got any prizes.
No. Do you know what?
Yeah.
I'm going to put something on the line here. There's a £20.
£20.
£20 Nando's voucher on the line here.
Wow. Yeah.
To win that digital voucher.
Yeah.
Is emailing the answers to these cryptic clues. Right. So, clue number one. You've got to get all of these to get the voucher.
Yeah, you said.
Okay. All right, cryptic clue number one. He loves a beanstalk, and his favourite colour is a kind of black mixed with white. He loves a beanstalk, and his favourite colour is a kind of black mixed with white. Tell you what, we'll do that as like a dummy question, see if you can get it.
Jack Grey?
Well, no, he's kind of black mixed with white.
Grey?
Yeah, you're on the right...
Grayson. Grayville. Jack. Jack? Jack? Jack. Jack. Are there any Jacks in the England squad? Jack Butler. No. Jack. Jack Graylish.
Yeah. We
Graylish. Grayish.
Grayish, yeah.
Jack Grayish.
Were you joking then, or were you just kind of like...
No, I was
to entertain me.
No, genuinely, that was my thought process.
But you said there were only Jacks in the England squad, but yeah.
Yeah, I just couldn't think. So, and I know that you're going to take quite deep offence to that, but I was trying to... Well, the only Jack that was just in my head was just Jack Butland. Couldn't get him out.
Okay.
Jack Graylish. Grayish.
So he loves a beanstalk. Jack loves a beanstalk.
Yeah, Jack, got that.
And kind of black mixes it, so it's like grayish. Jack Grayish.
Well, that's Grayish. His name's Jack Grealish.
Well, it doesn't matter. Anyway, right, yeah. First question is... Right. Fucking first question
come on,
for the
mate.
Tommy's cryptic clues.
Jesus Christ.
Right. The black and white bird got tangled in some metal rope. Who is it? Right. You got any ideas, Steph? Or don't shout out.
Yeah.
Question two. And they were ringing out for Christmas Day whilst also eating some cured meat. It's funny, isn't it? They were ringing out for Christmas Day, and they were also eating some cured meat.
Got that one.
Have you?
Yeah.
All right. Question three. Hot ball of gas and having that steak that took a few too many bites. It's a hot ball of gas, and you're also having a steak that took too many bites. Anything on that? Or?
No, nothing. Are we talking first name and surname for some of these?
Work it out yourself.
Mixture.
Question number four.
Fuck's sake.
The woman fended off the mugger with a spray and then walked up Everest. The woman fended off a mugger with a spray and then walked up Everest. Question number five. This is the bonus one for the voucher. This river was also a great and a cartoon character. So this river was also a great and a cartoon character, Steph.
Okay.
So,
not just England players, is it? All across
I'm not telling you.
No, fine.
I'm not telling you. Yep. So there's five.
Five for you.
Five. Get all five right. And if you're the first person to email in five correct answers,
yeah,
you win the voucher.
Well, am I paying £10 for this?
Yeah.
Listen, I think it's worth bringing the listeners in a little bit because you've actually, I mean, you've kind of been on the man on the inside this week. You've done what many people haven't done over this past year, 18 months. You've been to a football game.
Yeah.
More so, you've been to an England game.
Yeah.
You went to England, Austria.
Yeah.
You know, a famous 1-0 win. You know, really, you know, One for the ages. Yeah. And then
up at the Riverside,
yeah. And then you popped into the England camp. Taking sort of your dedication to the podcast to the next level. So,
Cheers, Steph.
Well, now clearly you've got, you know, a bit of insight, and you know, you had a quick chat with Gareth and a few of the lads and stuff. So I just wondered what sort of the vibe was in the camp and, you know, amongst the squad and stuff.
Yeah, no, do you know what? I had a bloody great time.
Yeah.
Went up to Rockcliffe Park in Middlesbrough. Lovely hotel and golf course.
Yeah.
Where the England boys are camping in.
Yeah.
Training, getting together, having a few jokes, bit of team bonding.
Yeah. What's the bonding? Do you see any insight into the bonding? Table tennis? Like, what's the bit just, golf? Or what's
do you know
the,
what?
Yeah.
I was up there and I was just like, bloody hell, it must be absolutely wonderful to be an England player. Major tournament, all the lads together, chatting about, you know, what they're going to do, training in the sun, having lunch together, going swimming, playing golf. They're just loving life, you know. It's all like Bellingham, Jadon Sancho and Ben Godfrey, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Which I didn't think, you know, he's just kind of slipped in there.
Yeah, yeah. Good.
And them three just having a right old laugh. Just walking to lunch in their little Louis Vuitton sliders.
Of course they were.
And I just thought, fair play to them. I was there on, to get the good content. And
What did you get? Who did you speak to? Now we splice in the interviews with Jack Grealish and Harry Kane.
Yeah,
and
I got the chance to speak to, you know, the likes of... Yeah, you know, Jordan Pickford.
Okay, well, cut that interview in now.
There's no point.
Now,
there, I got to speak to DCL, Dominic Calvert-Lewin.
Cut that interview in now. The chat about the podcast.
Well, it's about washing machines. And then the final player I got to speak to. Actually, two other players I got to speak to.
Yeah.
Harold of Kane.
Okay, good.
Yeah. He was just doing a few little shout outs to some mascots. Yeah. Just being like, oh, cheers for supporting me.
Did you speak to him on behalf of the podcast or not?
Well, I'll get on to that. Yeah. And then I also spoke to the shining light, the future hope, the King of England, Sir Jack Grealish.
Oh, wow.
And my interaction was minimal with him, I'm not going to lie. He would kind of walk past as we were just getting ready to film, and I went, oh, well played last night, Jack.
Pathetic.
Anyway, oh, cheers, mate. Lovely. He said cheers, mate.
Did he?
Yeah.
Cheers, Tom. I think, you know, as I say, I think it is good. You know, we've had a man on the inside, which is pretty big for this podcast over the years. We've earned it. But yeah, we didn't get the exclusives this time, but, you know, I'm sure they'll...
I'll try again. I'll try my bloody hardest next time.
Yeah. All right, Tom. Well, thanks for that insight. And listen, it wouldn't be a Tom and Steph podcast without me quizzing you on a few things. So I've got a new game for you. It's simple. It's like you can't go, like a monkey could do it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
It's called Aye Aye Captain. It's simple, mate. And you can play along at home. That's fine. Higher or lower international caps?
Brilliant.
I name a player.
Yeah.
I'll give you the caps of the first guy, and then I've got a few people that
are they captains?
No.
Oh right.
It's just how many caps they've got.
What's the name of this the quiz again?
Aye Aye Captain.
Got ya.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, I like this.
Okay, so...
Yeah. Nice.
First player I'm giving you.
Yeah.
We've mentioned him before. Podcast favourite. Sir Harold of Maguire. Yeah.
So,
you can have a guess, but then I will tell you, because you need to know whether to go higher or lower.
Right.
Okay, but how many caps do you think he's got?
He hasn't got that many.
Okay.
I'd say he broke in 2018.
Mm-hmm.
He'll have a few games before that. He might have a few friendlies.
Yeah.
Might have gotten the pitch before. I'm going to go for something like 20.
It's actually higher. It's 32 Harold Maguire. That's your bar. Next player, Jordan Pickford. What's your thinking here? What's your thinking?
I think Pickford. I think Pickford's been on the scene longer than Maguire.
Okay.
Just.
Okay.
And I think he might have played more games because of the lack of injury also. Because Maguire's been... Oh, he's not really been injured, has he, Maguire?
Higher or lower? Need an answer.
I'm going to go higher.
You're wrong. He's actually played for England 31 times.
That's fucking... That's close. I mean, give me a chance, isn't it?
It's close, isn't it? It's higher or lower. I mean, you know, one of them. Next player, John McGinn, a man close to your heart. Obviously for a different country, but how many times has John McGinn played for... Scotland. Is it higher or lower than 31?
I'm going to talk through me thinking.
Yeah.
Aston Villa legends, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
John McGinn. JMG7. I'm going to say that he has been a stalwart of that Scotland team. Not stalwart, but he's had more caps. And I'm going to go higher. Definitely higher.
Spot on, Tommy. 32 caps. Next player. Karim Benzema.
Is he going to be 31, 32 the whole way through?
Karim Benzema.
Benzema. Yeah. Right, easy, higher.
Yeah, that was higher.
Yeah.
I thought I might phase you there because he's had a bit of time out of the...
Nah, you ain't phasing me.
He had a bit of time out of the international fold after he had a bit of an incident with a teammate. But next player, Gareth Bale. Higher or lower than 82, Karim Benzema was? 82.
That's a good question. That's a very good question. Obviously, that talks to me thinking again.
Yeah.
Benzema, obviously older,
mm.
but obviously banned for the incident. Not banned, but banished, we'll call it.
Yeah.
Bale plays for Wales, but they're going to have less involvement in international tournaments.
But then potentially more friendlies, like who, you know.
Yeah, but they're not playing games during a tournament, are they?
No.
I'm going to go lower.
Sadly, you're incorrect.
What?
Gareth Bale played 91 times for his country.
Really?
He has, yeah. Which leads me on to the last one. Another friend of the podcast. Arkas Dias Milik. Milikit. Poland international. A player that I know you bloody love. Has he played for Poland more or less or fewer times than Gareth Bale's 91?
91.
Mm. Milik.
I mean, I can remember collecting Milik as a Euro sticker. A World Cup sticker for decades. He's always the one you've got 20 duplicates of. Mainly because we used to nick stickers by the bucket load at
Sainsbury's. Never proven
till proven guilty.
Yeah.
But yeah, Milik. Do you know what?
Yeah.
I'm going to say Milik's been. He's a journeyman, isn't he? He's been around for a while.
Yeah.
He's higher than Gareth Bale.
Nah, he's lower. 59 caps for Milik. So, always the same. I think that was 3 incorrect and maybe 1 or 2 right. So, some things never change. Cheers, Tom. Thanks for taking part.
Steph, this might get cut.
Yeah.
But it's a feature I wanted to pitch to you.
Yeah.
Just to get your thoughts on it. Just to be like, are you interested?
Yeah.
If you're not... been it.
Yeah.
But it's Thomas Steph's Football Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Already a very established company, Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Yeah,
but
it doesn't matter. This is a new twist on it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're a man who works in football, aren't you? You work for, you know, the Premier League, the nation's number one footballing association and sporting tournament in the football world.
Yeah.
Obviously, I do some little bits here and there in the footballing world, and I was thinking, can we?
go on.
Can we make someone's footballing wish come true between the two of us?
Between the two of us.
Yeah. So basically, if you know someone deserving of a footballing dream,
Like, are we talking like going to a game? Are we talking?
No. It's got to be realistic.
But, I mean, was that not realistic? Well, going to a game.
Okay, let's call that the baseline.
Okay,
you go to a game.
Right. Yeah.
You go to a game.
Yeah.
Or it could be anything.
Yeah.
But keep it realistic. You know, you're not going to be going on holiday with.
No.
You know,
you're with the lads.
With Zlatan Ibrahimovic.
No.
You're not going to be going out for a meal with.
No.
You know, Gareth Barry, right?
Yeah.
So Gareth keep Barry. It realistic.
Yeah.
But if you have got a footballing wish, maybe we could...
Pitch it in.
And if you've got a deserving story as well, because we're all about, you know...
And we've got contacts, I think.
Yeah.
Ultimately. You know, Jack Grealish called you mate. That's all I've got. That's it, actually.
I know Rocket from Soccer AM.
Yeah. Yeah, that could work. What, a little personalised message from Rocket?
I mean, that's
if that's
what your footballing dream is, then let us know because we can make that happen.
Yeah, no, I agree. Ultimately, this is a listener led.
Yeah, the thing is, I was just trying to come up with like a feature that was like giving back to the fans somehow, or like just being a bit more like open-minded or just kind of a bit more charitable, because
we're
3 years later, 3 years old or 3 years wide, so we need to be a bit better at, you know, we're both 33 years old now.
Yeah.
Can we be better in some way?
Yeah, so always self-improvement is really important, Tom.
Like maybe your partner or your child or whoever.
What they need,
just need a little shout out from Carl and Cole.
I can sort that out.
Send it in, TNS Europodcast 2021.
I can sort out a shout
at gmail.com.
I've got contacts.
With Carl.
With Carl. What's happening with that this
year?
What,
the Euro Song Competition?
Yeah. Last 2 years ago, we had some fantastic entries for
Ruben Loftus-Cheek.
Absolutely. And a couple of years before that, it was famously the Marcus Rashford
Song Competition. Now, listen. The thing is, Eurovision is a thing.
Yeah,
Eurovision
exactly.
is what sparks it all. So the Rashford competition was rife with entries.
Yeah.
People loved it. People were, we had about... You know, Andy Lester famously won it with his...
The rap.
The rap. Can't remember the artist. Biggie Smalls it was.
Biggie Smalls, yeah.
And obviously we had to continue it again in the World Cup. And again, fantastic entries.
Yeah.
James Firth then took the crown with his Spice Girls.
That was really good.
Ruben Loftus-Cheek concept. Yeah. And we're back to the Euros now. So this is it.
And look, Marcus Rashford, strength to strength. Ruben Loftus-Cheek, you know... He got relegated with Fulham, but he's still a footballer, and that's important. So the next, this player,
this player. What he's saying is going to go on strength.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay,
like all the previous.
Yeah. So the player for this year's Euro Football Competition Song Contest is, drum roll, please, Steph. It is one young Birmingham boy. Jude Bellingham. Now, your mind's racing, aren't you?
God, imagine.
You've heard that, Bellingham. It's gone into your head. Like, what rhymes with Bellingham? What rhymes with Jude? I will say now, Steph.
Yeah.
I will put down a marker.
Yeah.
A flagpole.
Yeah.
If anyone submits, hey, Jude.
Yeah.
You're getting minus points.
Banned straight away.
Banned.
Yeah.
Unless you absolutely nail it.
Okay.
If you nail hey, Jude...
Little remix,
fine.
Yeah,
but if it's a lazy Hey Jude,
yeah. Okay,
you gone.
Okay, and what are your thoughts on his fellow Birmingham boy Jack Grealish? Well, I know he was quite close to getting the nod for the song competition.
Well, he was. Jack Grealish was also, which is why this year, Steph, it's a bumper edition.
What?
It's a bumper edition, and there's going to be two Birmingham boys. The two Birmingham boys are up for grabs in the song competition.
Wow.
So you can either write a song for Jude Bellingham, or Jack Grealish. Or both. If you want to take Young Player of the Year and Player of the Season, you know, the two trophies, if you want to take the Golden Boot and the PFA Player of the Award, if you want to take them both, if you want to do the double, get them both in, is what I'd say. Or just take one and go with, if it feels right, just do a song for that one.
Okay.
It's your choice, basically. So, Steph, like, obviously, the excitement for the song contest is huge. This is one of the biggest events of the year,
is the
song
always.
Competition. And, people sending the songs, we judge them.
I genuinely
get real excitement from sending them in. Anyway, someone got wind of the song competition coming back, a.k.a. your brother, Christian Curtis.
Already?
Yeah.
He's had three shout-outs already.
I know, yeah. This is the sort of love you get if you're a fan of the show. Anyway, Steph, he sent a song in because this is before the player was announced, and this is just his song about England,
right?
Just to get people excited about the Euros. So, what do you think about this?
We've had some good players that have played for England in the past. But I'm confident that this group of players we've got now can do something to make us all proud. They can go to the next level. So let's name some good players that we've had. Some legends, Just like Jeff Hurst, Joe Cole, Tony Adams, Alan Ball, Stuart Pearce, Terry Butcher, Darren Anderton. Bobby Charlton, David Seaman, Alan Shearer, Paul Robinson, Gary Neville, Philip Neville, Gary Lineker. A few more. David Beckham, Gascoigne, David James, Sheringham, John Barnes, Paul Scholes, Wayne Rooney and Eric Dier, Michael Owen, Heskey, Stevie G and Banksy, Campbell King and Crouchy, Ferdinand and Terry. This England team's on fire. With this group of players we can get excited. This England team's on fire. Football's coming home, we're gonna win the Euros with Jadon Sancho, Rashford, Chilwell and Trippier, Kyle Walker, Calvin Phillips, Dean Henderson, John Stones, Luke Shaw, Tyrone Mings and Mason, Phil Foden, Declan and Big Dom up top. Southgate, Harry Kane, England's got a winning team. Connor, Cody, Bellingham, Trenty's out but Jesse's in. Hendo, Sam Johnson, Slabhead, that's Maguire, Bukayo, Raheem and not forgetting Grealish. This England team's on fire. With this group of players we can get excited. This England team's on fire. Football's coming home, we're gonna win the Euros.
Right. Wow.
Oh, bloody hell. He never ceases. You know what I find sort of impressive and curious in equal measures is he's got two little lads just running around the house probably while he's recording that and coming up with the lyrics and stuff. So, you know.
If he's got a full-time job and two kids and he's managed to pull that off in 12 hours.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, he's really set the bar, I think, there, Steph, in terms of what kind of creativity you can come up with.
I completely agree. Yeah. Fair play to you, boy. Yeah. And that's not even his Jude Bellingham or Jack Grealish song.
No. There's more to come from young Christian Curtis.
No doubt about it.
Obviously, we've gone another podcast without talking about football at all. Yeah. The Euros.
Yeah.
We've got a tough group as well.
Yeah, we have got a tough group.
The thing is, I could easily see us just losing 1-0 to Croatia.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah, and then Scotland are really
and
up
then
for
Scotland
it.
Scotland are up for it, they just beat us.
Well, and then we're out.
And then we both go out and Czech Republic and Croatia go through.
Yeah.
I mean, let's not put a damper on it. I genuinely think we're going to do one better than we did in the World Cup, Steph.
Get to the final.
I genuinely believe we're going to get to the final.
Bloody hell.
And it's a flip of a coin from there.
Yeah.
It's a flip of a bloody coin because I don't know what's going to happen. But I think as long as Maguire's back, because he's key, because United were at sixes and sevens without him the other night in the Europa League final. And I think England are going to look shaky without him. Stonesy, Maguire, if they're back and the front three are firing, I think all the games at Wembley, we're going to have the home fans behind us.
Trafalgar Square
is going to be rocking.
You know, let's stay positive, Tom.
Let's stay positive. So you're saying we're going to get...
I think we're going to win it.
And I'm saying we're going to get to the final.
Yeah, or we lose our opening two games 1-0 and, you know, slump out.
Steph, TP Bet is back.
Yeah.
It's the new cryptocurrency. It's going to be an absolute windfall, essentially, this summer. More money making.
How many have you ever won?
Tips than ever before.
How many have you won?
And there's a lovely... lovely offer
on
Skybet at the minute. This is genuine. Just listen up, alright? This is a genuine good tip. So Skybet are doing an offer where if you stick a tenner on the top goal scorer of the Golden Boot winner of the Euro 2021/21 season, every time they score you get a free £3 bet.
So
it could pay for itself. If a player scores three goals, pay for itself.
Quid down.
So what I've done is I've stuck it on Harry Kane.
Okay.
Tenner on Harry Kane.
Okay, good. Is that your big top tip?
Yeah, just stuck a tenner on Harry Kane.
Come on without yourself, have you?
About 7-1.
Yeah.
Top goal scorer. Hopefully, he'll bang a few in.
Yeah.
Yeah. The second bet that I've got, Steph.
Yeah.
50-1.
Okay.
France to win the Euros.
Yeah.
Which goes against everything that I've said and you've said and what this podcast stands for.
First time we've mentioned France, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Benzema, top goal scorer.
Wow.
Because let's not beat around the bush. Benzema is one of the top strikers in Europe.
He knows where the goal is, doesn't he?
He knows where the bloody goal is and he puts them away, left, right and centre.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, he's back in the France squad. He's looked sharp in training. He's going to have a team of incredible players behind him.
Yeah.
Mbappe feeding him, Pogba feeding him, Griezmann feeding him. Yeah, he's going to be leading the line as the number nine.
Yeah.
He's not on pens, which is an issue.
Who's on pens?
I'm guessing it's Pogba.
Yeah, okay. He might be, we don't know.
He might be. So yeah, basically I've put a fiver on Benzema, top goal scorer in France to win the Euros at 50-1.
Okay. Yeah, good luck to you.
TP bet. Put your money where your mouth is.
Is that your slogan?
TP bet.
Is that your slogan?
What was the slogan?
You did it a minute ago.
He was like, make money.
For fuck's sake.
Make more money than you
ever lose
ever dreamed of.
Yeah.
Make millions.
Yeah.
TP bet.
Millions. How much? What's the payout on that one?
All about
5 quid at 50-1.
Big Wonga with TP. Wonga.
Forget it.
Life savings to life.
Forget
dreams.
It. Forget it. Forget it. You had a good logo. You had a song.
Cash in, cash out.
I think that ultimately brings an end to episode one.
Bets.
Because we've covered a variety of subjects here. This could be our longest ever episode. Famously, we've sort of tittered around the 20-minute mark, but there's been demand for some longer episodes. So, you know, particularly during this time where people are working at home, got people in car journeys. One of our friends, Dave Whitaker, famously listened to a podcast while his wife was giving birth to twins. I hope they're both doing well, Dave.
We've got listeners all around the world.
We have Ben Williams over in Australia. I know he used to listen on his commute. You know, we've got friends in New Zealand as well, James Rigby, and all sorts.
I mean, obviously we've got the podcast long-term fans as well. We've got, you know, your Dan Hamers, your
That group. I mean, look, we could sit here all day and listen to, you know, our very comprehensive fan base, but ultimately it's up to them to get in touch with us.
Yeah. The thing is, this podcast doesn't really get rolling until, you know, the fan interaction comes in. You know, the people's send the messages in, the questions, the songs,
anything
you've got. And
episode one is always the sort of the nervy first episode, you know, where you're sort of hoping people are still listening.
Yeah.
So yeah, you know, the bars. I say it's been set, but it hasn't really been set. But
yeah,
you know, we did get some good interaction in 2018. So you know where we are. You know, we don't know where you are until you get in touch with us. Yeah. So it's kind of a cry for help, really.
Yeah.
We don't want to get Sir Simon Wesley involved.
No. But that's it, Steph. We're back. That's episode one done. All the same shit. Same nonsense. Minimal football chat. How do you think it went? Don't know how it was.
Came in with low expectations, didn't we?
So, Steph.
Yeah.
I'd say 5% football chat.
Just nice to sit down and have a chat with you, Tom, to be honest.
Yeah,
you know,
a couple of beers.
Yeah,
chatting about football. But yeah, we're going to be back, episode two. We'd love to hear from you. tnseuropodcast2021@gmail.com.
yeah, it's almost fitting in a way that the heartbreak from our last episode, well, you know, the last meaningful episode, at least in the 2018 World Cup podcast, was that Croatia game, and they're first up. It's, yep, you know, it's poetry in a way. You know, we get to right some wrongs, hopefully.
Yep. Cheers, Steph.
All right, boy. All the best. Take care.
See you later.
See you later.
Love you guys. Bye-bye.